Hello, everybody. I am Teddy Jenkins, and welcome to the Elderly Gentleman Podcast. As always, I am your host, Teddy Jenkins. Now, I am starting this before anybody else gets here, because I decided I wanted to mix it up today. And I thought, hey, why not do that? Why not just, you know, not wait? Just do it, you know? So, today, we will be talking about the Super Bowl. Not just the Super Bowl, as you might think. Aw, Super Bowl. I either love the Super Bowl or I either hate the Super Bowl, which is everyone's point. We're going to be talking about the comparisons between real sports and esports, and whether or not things like, well, is esport a real sport, or is it just a video game? Or yeah, here they come. So we're going to be quiet, right, and act like.
So I'm in a good mood.
All right, cool. All right, so you ready to begin? Slow spawn. Slow spawn.
Yeah.
Okay, respond.
I was responding.
Well, you were cutting up if you were. All right, here we go. All right, 3, 2, 1. Hello, everybody. I am Teddy Jenkins, as always, your host of the Nerdly Gentleman Podcast, and with me is my host, Slow Spawn. Say hi. Slow Spawn. Say hi. Okay, fine. Riptide, you're the other host this time. You say hi.
Hello.
Clap. Okay.
Thank you. I'll be signing autographs.
Yeah, autographs will be signed outside the main window.
Dude.
I got the Viking helmet. Okay.
What?
Don't worry about it.
Are you playing Dota?
No, I'm playing Gang Beasts as always. You know, the thing that I play every single time that we do this. Anyway. So, why don't you tell everybody what we're going to be playing today?
Playing?
I mean, not playing, talking about it. Who cares?
Super Bowl.
No.
What's going on right now?
Riptide, you tell them what we're talking about. I told you, and you can remember things better.
Be talking about the Super Bowl and how real sports and esports are related.
Yes, we are. So, Slow Spawn, who's playing in the Super Bowl? Because I don't care.
The Panthers and the Broncos.
Okay, Panthers and Broncos, yeah.
Ted is not a big sports guy, but basically, yeah.
Now, you know what I do know, though? I know who's doing the halftime show. Did you guys hear about who it is?
Yeah, it's going on right now, and I'm not paying attention to it because I don't care.
How can you say you love the Super Bowl, but you don't care about the halftime show? Many people watch Super Bowl entirely for commercials. There are people who do that. Mm-hmm. Because the commercials
are horrible.
Oh, please. They're not all horrible. There's some good ones in there. A couple good ones. And then there's other people who tune in only for the halftime show.
Not this year.
Riptide, why don't you ask a very provocative and thought-provoking question about our topic?
I don't have any questions.
Well, create one. I didn't say ask a question that you've come up with in your head already. Create a question. Be spontaneous.
Got the wrong person for that.
Slow spawn. Okay, and you know what? No, not slow spawn. You're gonna ask. Why? Football. Because you're gonna ask a football question. And I don't want to.
Yes.
I don't want to answer. I don't want to.
It's football about Sunday. Halftime show's going on right now. We got to talk about it, dude.
Like, what are we going to say? What are we really thinking? Okay. I'm serious. There's nothing you can say. It's happening right now. So,
did you know Michael Orr got traded to the Panthers?
I guarantee you 99% of our audience has no clue who that is.
So, have you seen The Blind Side?
No. No one understands what you're saying right now, probably.
I've seen it. Dude, lots of people seen the Blind Side. It's a very inspirational movie.
Our audience has seen it.
Possibly. I've seen it, and I watch YouTube videos of video game people.
Okay. Well. Okay, Riptide. Say something about our topic. I don't know. Anything. Say whatever you want. Or just restate the topic, and then we can talk about the topic. How about that?
How esports are related to real sports.
Okay. All right, Riptide, say something about that. Say something about that.
What am I supposed to say about it?
Well, you're on here.
Got probably close to the same level of competitiveness.
Let me ask you this, Riptide.
Let's break down. Hang on.
Riptide, can I ask you a question, all right? Do you think esports should be and this is primarily because of ESPN creating an entirely esports section now. Riptide, do you think that esports should be considered real sports? And why?
Well, they are.
Well, okay, that wasn't the question, though. You can't just say, well, they are. I could say the moon is made of cheese, and if somebody asked me, well, how do you know that? And I could just say, because it is.
I'd like to answer the question.
Okay, so why don't you answer the question?
Okay, I believe they're real sports, and that is because those sports take not more training necessarily or less training, but they take training nonetheless to perform. So it's if you're working towards something like that, you can't just say it's not a sport just because you don't think so. Those people work hard, whether you want to believe it or not. I mean, granted, it could be a little easier than some sports, Koreans, or it could be a little less easy, but you don't know.
StarCraft, is a really big
sport. Yeah, StarCraft, perfect example.
Koreans will spend years, all day, every day, just years playing StarCraft to become a pro.
And
there's colleges.
You can
just
even
go to careers, especially to learn to play StarCraft.
Especially though, if you see something like take a League of Legends for example. You know, I've seen people. I saw one team being interviewed at the League of Legends Worlds tournament, and one of them was like, we train 8 hours every day, and play this game, and everybody likes, I think most people like video games. Most people could probably say that they could stand, or at least stand to play a video game. Imagine though, your job, not for fun, your job is to play a video game 8 hours every day. That's mandatory of your life.
I mean, it's a little repetitive. I've that's why I can never do that, because I'd be frustrated with video games at that point.
I know, yeah. Riptide, what do you think about that?
I'd probably have to agree on slow spawn. I would get really bored of playing a game that much. I used to switch back and forth between games every day. I hated doing that, but I just did. Now Ooh. I've started to actually play games and not keep switching. But I think if I played a game for that long, I'd get really bored of it.
Mm-hmm. Okay. This is very boring right now.
Well, you guys have not that much sports knowledge, and you're not asking me questions. Who does know about sports?
Let me ask you this. All right, what is it you would like to say?
I can tell some football stories. Just do some football related stuff, since that's the current event that we are currently going over.
Yeah, but
Hey, why don't we talk about the Super Bowl, and then talk about esports, and then talk about how they're related?
Okay. So let me ask. Slow Spawn, I have a question for you. Why is football good? And I'm not looking to argue about this. I'm curious on your actual opinion. Why do you like football?
Why do I like football?
Yeah. What is it that appeals to you in any way? Not saying that's. I'm not saying that's bad. I'm not saying that's bad. I'm just. I don't know. I'm curious though.
I'm the guy who likes order and I like rules, and I go to a school where that's enforced heavily. So you can't, you know, you can't be physical. There's no fighting. There's no messing around. And I'm someone who follows that and under and goes by that. But sometimes, just as a person, you need to let loose and release some energy, release some frustration or emotion. And football is my outlet for that. And that's why one of the perks of being a football player is you have a weight room and you get to work out whenever you really feel like it. So that's one of the nice perks about being a football player is I have an outlet for emotion or just anything in general. And football for me is that. Also, football, I feel like, has helped shape me as a person. And it's given me a lot more character and a little bit stronger morals than I feel like I would have had if I didn't play football. So it helps shape a person a little bit more than people would think.
Okay. Well, I got to say, I'm super biased in this entire endeavor. Because
why is that? What is your opinion on it?
On sports in general or just football?
We'll do both. Do both. Let's do sports in general, and then you can talk about football. Why?
Oh yeah. Well, there are lots of sports I think that are really cool. All right. I think there's plenty of sports that I seriously commend anybody for playing. For instance, I think that it takes serious guts to play soccer. I know a lot of people might say otherwise. But dude, you gotta headbutt a soccer ball as your job. I mean, I couldn't do that. I couldn't headbutt a soccer ball every day. To me, that would just be.
I'm not gonna argue that because I have some very strong opinions about soccer because of how my school is set up, and that's a story for maybe later.
But here's the thing I gotta say. I really think it's a cool sport. The idea that you cannot touch it with your hands in any way, that you gotta use everything else. Now, I gotta say, it's not cool that people get, you know, concussions and everything from it and stuff like that. That was loud. But I do think it's very cool, though, just the idea of it, the rules, the all that. And also, I like the idea that it's an international sport. You know, like, for instance, football is not an international sport. And it probably never will be.
No.
But it's, you know.
The game, we know it. It will definitely change soon. So maybe it could be, but I highly doubt it will be.
But it's an American here's, okay, thing. So here's the other thing I got to say. I feel like there's a lot of ways. These are kind of just personal opinions that, to me, watching a sport is not supremely entertaining. And that I think.
Oh, I agree with that.
Okay, you agree. So here's this.
The only reason I ever watch football is to watch either myself to see how I can get better. But I'll watch the NFL and I have teams I.
Now, support, here's the thing. I won't argue.
But that, I'm not. I don't enjoy it that much.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I'm not trying to argue necessarily that why sports aren't fun or entertaining or whatever. Because ultimately, I mean, it's your choice if you want to enjoy something or not. You know, I can't tell you why something isn't entertaining. So I mean, if you know, like I think playing football is fun. The like two times that I've played it in my entire life. But I think it's more of the idea of watching sports for entertainment that really kind of, it just sort of annoys me. Not like, you know, like I said, I'm not trying to judge people for what entertainment they want to watch. But I feel like there's a lot of ways that, you know, places like things like the NFL could improve upon the sport to make it more easy to view. Like, okay, here's a great example. NASCAR. NASCAR is one of the most boring sports I think I have ever seen. Many people would probably want to argue against that, but here's the thing. It's just cars going in a circle.
No, it is. This is what it is. Ted. Okay, are you ready? This is the NASCAR commentating. Okay. I just did my acting face. Oh my gosh, he's there hard, didn't he? He took a left turn. Oh my god. What's he doing right there? Oh my gosh, he took a left turn!
And see, that's the thing. That's the thing is that ultimately, at least to me, to an outsider of the NASCAR world, it seems like whoever has the fastest car is going to win. Usually. You know, well, look at it this
There's
way.
There's a lot of stuff that goes into NASCAR, actually, that you'd be surprised.
That might be true, but what I'm saying is that
and it's hard to drive. Doesn't seem... Those suckers are really hard to drive.
Yeah, but
there's a lot of skill.
Okay, my point though is that at least to a viewer, we'll just stick to the viewer perspective, not the actual what you know it's like being in NASCAR or anything like that. But I'm saying it's boring. There's nothing that really happens. So I always thought this would make it just wonderful. And I know, okay, the things I'm probably going to talk about of ways that sports could be more viewable will sound insane. Did somebody just leave?
Well, Spawn just left.
Oh, great. Okay. Is he still gone?
Yeah.
Okay.
Just keep talking.
Okay, so the things that I'm probably going to say about to make sports better will probably seem insane and impossible, and they will probably be impossible. But okay, NASCAR. To me, the thing that would make NASCAR amazing is if it was like Speed Racer, in which every car was different. Which this sounds super dumb, okay? I admit that, but
you got to different types of cars.
But here's
like,
the thing:
like the reason they use the cars they do in NASCAR, it's because those cars are the fastest.
But okay, look at it this way:
unless you want something like a super, like really low to the ground, a lot of it's based off of aerodynamics, like what can go through the air the fastest.
Yeah, but that's really... here's the thing, right? Is that if all the cars had like stuff built into them that could help them win. So I'm talking like, and this is super insane and fantastical, but like imagine if like, you know, there's one car has nitro built into it and another one has like an oil slick, and this sounds super cartoony and I realize that, and another one has, I don't know, spiked tires so it can go up stuff slopes much easier and stuff like that.
Teddy, I'm gonna stop you there. That's not realistic.
I know that.
I understand your thought, but this is like never gonna happen.
But think about if it did. All right, let's just say that it could. Let's just say that any of our ideas could be made, no matter how insane they were. So, Spawn, what would you do to make NASCAR more viewable and entertaining?
If I could do whatever I wanted with a sport and anything's realistic.
Whatever. I'm talking like if you want to make it so that in football it's just a blood sport and like guys can go out there with like chainsaws and fight each other, you can totally do that. We won't say whether or not we're not going to say that it's right or wrong because it is. Because it's obviously wrong, but you get my point. Is that just hands down? What could you do to NASCAR to make it super entertaining? Slow Spawn?
Like extremely crazy.
You're cutting out, Slow Spawn. Okay, we're gonna wait till you stop cutting out. For now, Riptide, what do you think?
What do I think about how football could be made better?
Yeah, about how how NASCAR could be made to be more entertaining. We're going to just go through some general sports.
Well.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. Obviously, what you're saying would make it more interesting, even though it's like not really possible at this time.
But if you I'm that's true, at this time I would agree with that. But here's the other biggest thing is that I always thought if the race cars could hit each other, that would be significantly more entertaining. And over time they kind of added that rule in where you could like bump people, but not then they I think they chain took it away, or then it went back but they altered it. I don't know, they tried to implement that rule but in a much more passive and wuss kind of way. I'm talking like road rage style Mad Max driving. Like if you could just, you know, put whatever you want on your car, put spikes on it, put flamethrowers, put anything on it, and then you can just smash a car to pieces to win, if that's what it took. You know, like a no holds barred style race car.
Yeah,
race.
It'd be very dangerous.
It would be, but remember we're excluding realism entirely from this. So this would of course like cause several deaths, of course.
Well, but if we're excluding realism, why don't we just race on the moon?
That would be also really
good. Yeah, no, that goes into my point before my mics start cutting out. I want to have like crazy courses. Like you can go through a freaking volcano or something.
Yeah, so that's why I said it. I think it would be cooler if it was like Speed Racer. You know, like you go into like crazy different places and you just have all sorts of like gadgets on these cars to make them do all sorts of stuff. Like, you know, I don't want to say that, excluding total realism, if there was an actual Speed Racer that had like, you know, the wheel had the buttons on it and it had like saw blades and jump things and all that sort of stuff, that would be awesome to see. You got to admit that would be really fun to watch, like so many cars race to the finish and just try to destroy each other on the way there. I mean, look at Mad Max. People love Mad Max. That was a great Fury Road was a great movie. And that's all it was. It was just cars driving constantly and destroying each other. So, I mean, I think that's proof that it would be more entertaining. Don't you guys think so?
Yeah.
Okay, so now I want to go to football. What could be done to football to make it more viewable and entertaining? For the viewer, anyway. The same rules apply. No, realism does not matter at all.
Slow spawn.
I'm sorry, what?
Slow spawn. What do you think?
You cut out for me that last part. Just rephrase the.
Okay, what do you think could be done to make football more entertaining? And the same rules of.
Okay,
everything
well,
is. Either,
I've
no
seen
realism.
Like the.
Go ahead.
Well, the most entertaining I've seen like done with fantasy football was the one game. It's like Blood Battle or something. It's some
yes.
Steam game.
Yeah,
and
it's like
is, yeah. So basically, spikes on the pad, spikes on the helmet. And it's like freaking ogres
versus dwarves and like elves and just they can murder each other with like clubs and stuff if they want to. I know that sounds really messed up, but you gotta admit it would be a little bit more entertaining than seeing two guys tackle each other over a sweaty football. Just a little.
I mean, it's already sort of entertaining, but it just you have to sort of be emotionally invested in like your team or the players themselves. You have to know them a little bit.
And
like I enjoy football watching my team because I know the guys. I'm like, oh my gosh, D-Paul just got a big tackle. Go, D-Paul, you got this, or something like that.
Mm.
So really, it's more so you have to have a connection to the sport itself, or you have to have some reference to it. Like you've had to have experience with the sport itself before you can really enjoy it. Some people just enjoy watching it.
I
know I enjoy it because of my experience.
I just had an awesome idea. What if it was football, all right? But all the football players were UFC fighters, and they could use any UFC moves they wanted. So, like, you got people running with a football, and then one dude puts him in, like, an arm bar all of a sudden. And then it's like, you know what I mean? Like, wouldn't that be cool if, like, you could do, like, judo kicks on people as in football? Anybody? No? Hello?
Shh. It's okay, Dad.
What?
Dad.
Dude, seriously, okay. I hate it when you guys just don't respond. Because it means...
No. We're in a private chat. We're just talking to each other. We're like, hey, let's just not talk to Ted for the next 10 minutes. Just for the sake of comedy.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
What do you think about that idea, though, of just having football players be UFC fighters, and they could use any UFC moves they wanted?
I mean, it sort of ruined the sport because you got to run the ball. It'd just be like a giant brawl.
It wouldn't be football. More like rugby.
Yeah. But from,
that's already a sport.
I've never actually seen rugby, but from what I've heard of it, it sounds awesome. The idea that it's like just get the ball to the end of the goal any means necessary. I know that sounds that might sound real horrible, but I think
snap his neck. You can't tack you with broken neck.
Dude, you sound like what's his name from Karate Kid, the master of the like black dragons, when the guy's telling him, "Hey, break his leg. He can't fight without a leg." And then he breaks his leg and he's like, "Oh, whoops, I totally didn't tell that random kid to break that other kid's leg. I mean, I'm just this wise
sweep
sensei."
The leg.
You sweep
the
leg.
You ever seen Karate Kid? Sweep the leg.
Yeah. Oh, man. That movie's good.
Hey, Riptide. Sweep the leg.
Sweep the leg. Wash, wax on, wax off.
Yes. And then stand on the pole and kick.
Okay, I gotta say this. If gladiator sports came back today,
that'd be awesome. Horrible, but awesome.
Do you think people would enjoy
it? It'd help with the population increase.
Do you think that they
would? Oh yeah, dude.
People, I'm serious though. Like, let's say it became legal that you could kill someone in a sport. Right.
I mean, people today are a little sensitive towards stuff like that. Like, I mean, it's a horrible thing, like, to kill another person, obviously, and I'm not, like, but, condoning it or saying it's okay.
Yeah.
But I'm saying that would be so entertaining. Like, it's a horrible thing, and it's bad, but it would be entertaining.
I think
still.
I used to think, how could the Romans ever find the murder of two men entertaining? The brutalization of them.
The Romans were tough, dude. They gave no craps.
But I think,
although you should have heard about what the freaking Spartans were. Spartans were crazy.
Oh,
they'd
yeah.
take the, they'd have the elders take a baby on a cliff, and if they're like, "This baby is weak," they'd leave him, and then they'd like be like, "All right, next baby."
Yeah, well, yeah. But the
Spartans were rough.
But you know, after I thought about it, I kind of realized, you know, there's always some part of our brains that enjoy violence, just a little, no matter how, you know, bad we know it is. I think that's the part of the nature of man that enjoys doing bad things. There's like, people enjoy doing bad things ultimately. Some part of them, I'm not saying completely, that or that they think they morally think it's right or right. But there is a part that of our, I suppose, soul, that does want to do evil. You know, that does want to be able to revel in violence or anything. I mean, you think about it, right? It's the same thing of like the mob mentality. You know, like, you think, you look at a mob and you go, "How could all these people be doing getting into this big mob?" But then, when you're in the situation, you're like, I think there's a small part of that everyone's brain that goes, "Yes, I get to let out any and all frustrations I want." You know, like, a mob is almost like a way of being more.
Well, going back
free
to that,
of,
going back to that, that sort of brings back all the way around to my point about football. That's my release. That's the way I don't kill people.
Yeah.
That's how I don't join mobs.
Yeah, and I mean, I think there's a ton of football players though who have had that exact same story of, you know, like, they would have joined gangs or any number of things that would have made their lives horrible had they not been in football. And you know, I mean, there's tons of like NFL players today who have that exact same kind of story. So I mean,
Michael Orr.
I just want to make sure. I just want to OJ Simpson. Oh, man. Okay, you gotta admit that was a little bit funny. Just a little.
No.
No, really? An OJ Simpson? Is it too soon to make an OJ Simpson joke? Is it really?
Yes.
Okay.
Riptide, what do you think?
I don't know.
He's really contributing to the conversation.
He really is. He's always quiet, though.
Hey, Riptide. Wake up. Or I will slap you.
Okay, so now let's now that we talked about regular sports, let's move on to esports. So, I gotta say, esports can also be very boring. So, who here has seen any match of esports in anything? It could be you know, Counter Strike.
No, you and Riptide should be talking about this because I have no clue anything about esports. All right.
So, Riptide, would you agree that esports can be really boring?
They can. It sometimes it just depends on what you're watching, like what game you're watching.
But here's the thing, like Slow Spawn said, I think a big part of it is that you gotta really love your team. Like for instance, I tried to watch Worlds.
In esports, you don't really have to have a team.
That's true, but you gotta be invested.
Watch the games.
That's true, but I feel like you gotta be a little bit invested in one particular team. Otherwise, for instance, League of Legends, all right? I had I tried to watch Worlds, League of Legends Worlds tournament. And the thing with it was, I had no clue what was happening. Because, not because I had not played League of Legends or anything, but because it's almost like it's too complex. You know, like it's too, like for instance, plus, anyone who has never played League of Legends or is not very good at it won't have any clue what is happening. You know?
Yeah. But, I mean, same thing with, like, a normal sport. If some
person
that's never watched football before goes and watches football, they're not going to have any idea what's happening.
That's true. However,
the thing with esports, though, is that
watching it
on like a video site like YouTube can have a different effect than watching it like in game or something. Like if you're watching Dota 2 matches, it's better to be in game because you can like explore the map yourself and do stuff like that. But if you're just watching it on YouTube, you have to have the commentator's view.
I will say this though, the commentators are not very good at making it very approachable because they're using only terminology that someone who has played League of Legends has. You know, like, in football, they try to kind of make the terms more understandable and more approachable, I'll say. Slow Spawn, would you agree with that?
Saying, yeah.
Is he gone? Okay. Don't worry about it.
Call.
For instance, a touchdown, okay? You could figure out what a touchdown is. You could figure out how football works just from watching a one match of football. I mean, you could probably do the same with League of Legends. However, there's a significant higher amount of strategy in League of Legends to where like you have to understand the strategy of it to enjoy it, I feel. Yeah. You know,
most
like you can't
esports would have more strategy than normal sports.
I would totally agree with that.
That's my opinion.
There's totally definitely more because I think that's the difference between esports and regular sports is that esports are like mental sports more than at physical sports, you know? You know what I mean? Like, it's not like chess, you know? Like, there's a difference between, you know, people might want to say that they're both sports, but like, chess isn't like football, you know? Like, it's not an athletic sport. It's a mental sport, you know? Like, it's about brains over brawn. And so you know, you could kind of put chess and esports in the same category in some ways, just because of how they both require your mental capabilities versus your physical capabilities.
Yeah. And I feel like people who play esports spend more time practicing than people who play real sports.
Well, I might disagree with you on that. That
I mean,
could
sometimes it
be.
really just depends on which game.
Yeah, like we need slow. We really need slow spawn here. But you know, I always thought though that. Okay, good. Slow spawn. You're back. You're back. Okay,
I'm
slow spawn.
sorry, it's
Slow spawn.
crappy.
Okay, who do you slow spawn? How many hours a day do people practice for football?
Okay. There's a lot of anti-stat questions. Okay, so in season or off season, because there's like no stop to our practices.
Okay, well, if we're comparing it to esports, then I suppose in season, since, I mean, well,
Okay,
do,
in
do
season?
well, what
Okay,
do
well
you,
there's like
Riptide, do you
both.
think that, is there, is, do they only really practice when they're in season, like, practice, you know, like the
No,
8 hours?
we do.
No,
We
I'm talking about,
have.
like, esports, though, like Riptide,
Oh.
okay,
Yeah,
is,
because
they can't just not play for.
yeah, okay, but
We have
do
about
they play
there's
as
also
much,
an
like, do they
hour.
keep, but like Riptide, do they keep that regimen of, you know, like practicing 8 hours every day, even when they're not in season?
Well, the thing is, there's not really a season per se. There's
Yeah.
more like just events that they go to, and they just keep on practicing from the different events.
Okay, so they practice all year basically. Like they
Yeah.
practice pretty much all the time. Okay, so let's want to continue with what you're. Why don't you tell us what the how often they play in season and out season? Slow spawn. Oh no. Oh, great. Oh. Slow spawn. Slow spawn. Slow spawn.
Okay, can you hear me
Slow
now?
spawn. Yes. Okay.
Just let me
So,
answer the question.
okay. Yeah. Go ahead. Go ahead.
Okay. Basically, so off season, it's literally just an hour long. Mostly we'll do weightlifting stuff, but there's agility days and stuff like that.
How
But
often,
in
like,
season,
how many days a week or something like that?
all school days, all weekdays. Weekends, we have our own we have our own commitments we make. And for in season, I mean, the season really starts during summer when summer starts, because that's when we start doing events in the morning. Like we'll start showing up at the school and doing practices. It's not as intense as when we start playing games, but that would be that's about 3 hour long practice, and sometimes it'll go 3 hours and 30 minutes. That's when we have games. Our practices after school would be like that long, but from like a summer stance, there's a week called Hell Week where they like it's a few weeks before we actually start playing games, and we go basically all day. It's like a camp. It's really intense, and for a week we basically just hang out, show up for be 7 hours, and go over plays, play games. They'll feed us. It's really intense for Hell
So,
Week.
okay, so may I ask, do you have any idea what it's like? Is that similar to like the schedule that say professional football players have? Or like college or anything like that? Like, do you have any idea
Oh
what
no.
schedule like theirs would be?
That's their job. And for
Yeah,
college, they're
so they
getting
don't really have
scholarship
like
rights.
school or
So it's
something
a
to
little bit
keep them
more.
away. Yeah, so that's what
Yeah,
I was
no,
wondering
college
since.
guys get, first of all, they get away with a lot for when they're in football. Like people just buy them. Like my brother, he went to Ole Miss. He's talking about how like when he went out to bars, the football players would be just hanging out and people buy him beer just for the heck of it. So the college guys, they don't have many problems when it comes to that. Obviously, sports and schooling is very difficult, and you know they deserve a lot of respect for being able to do that and balancing it. But they get it a little bit easier because they do football, and their schedule is definitely a lot it's similar, but it's not the same. They put in a lot of more work than us.
So how many hours did you say a professional football player puts in a day?
Okay, professional, like NFL-wise, that's his job. So that's workouts twice, maybe three times a day. And when they start practicing again as a team, which is probably summer,
Fall?
like they probably get a
Oh,
month or two off and they do their personal stuff. And they also have personal trainers. They'll probably have a practice a day, maybe two, and obviously their personal training commitments because they all get personal trainers. So.
yeah. So, like, how long do you think one workout session for them lasts? If you had to guess, just, you know.
I mean, you don't want to burn yourself out so you can't do it again. And you don't want to like work too much on a certain muscle group, otherwise you'll strain it and it just isn't good. So maybe an hour, maybe 2 hours, because those guys are really tough. So, but then again, their bodies develop a lot easier considering like their weight can affect them a lot more. Like me and younger guys like us, you know, our metabolisms are very good. So we don't gain weight or gain muscles easy. Just because our body digests the food so quickly, if that makes sense. So it's really hard for me just to gain weight and gain muscle because of that. But like when I turn 20 something, I'll start probably being able to gain a little weight and that helps put on more muscle. So basically my restriction would be age. For them, they don't have that restriction.
So the you I'm not sure if you could hear it or not, but Riptide said that he thought that esports players probably practiced more than regular sports players. So would you say that that's true or wrong? Sussman.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. Oh no, he's cutting out again. Riptide, what do you think though after hearing that?
Well, like I said, it really depends which game. Like, people that would play, I don't know, like Call of Duty, like FaZe, I know they don't practice all the time. But like StarCraft, the Koreans practice all day, like as much as they can.
Like it's like their life.
Usually, no,
Can you hear me now?
I don't really want to make that comment, so it
So,
kind of sounds racist.
okay.
So here's a question.
Yeah, I
Which
can
would you
hear you
guys?
guys. I heard your question too, if you want me to answer it.
Okay, you want to answer it? Go ahead, you can go ahead.
Okay, so yeah, they probably do put in more hours, and that's really fine. I'm not offended by that or anything, but it's more because football is a more physical sport, obviously, so that we're limited by how much we can take and all that. For gamers, it's more just how much they want to do, how long they can stay awake, really, because they can do that for however long they need to do. Football, it's our bodies have our limit, is our limit. So,
Yeah, that's true.
Slow spawn, or everyone, I'm
yeah.
curious as a final question, I suppose. Which would you prefer to be, an actual sports player or a esports player? Slow spawn, I imagine I know what your answer is going to be.
Esports, actually.
Really? Really? If you could be, if you
Okay, let
could
me explain
be.
my answer though. It's because professional sports, I respect it a lot, and I understand it takes a ton of work, and I don't think I'll ever be that good. I practice a heck ton. I practice a lot more than most people do too, but I'm just not. I don't have the natural talent for that, and I've accepted that. But if I were to be that good, it costs a toll on your body. To the point where I don't know if I'd really want that because it would,
All those
there'd be a lot
concussions,
of
man.
arthritis, a lot of pain.
All those
Yeah, all those
concussions.
concussions, they start taking their toll when they start hitting you. And esports, I mean, your hands are sore, I guess. That's the worst. You're not very physical.
Well, I mean,
but I can.
Yeah, I mean, the worst physical injury you can get is like a hand injury, which I think a couple of them have gotten, but like nothing that's like
cramps, hand cramps. Yeah.
Well, some of them, dude, you wouldn't believe. Some of them have like sprained their wrists. I mean, like broke. I don't know if anybody's broken their hand or anything, but some of them have actually had like hospital. No, I'm serious. Like hospital-worthy injuries that they've gotten.
Because they don't sleep.
Yeah, but that's it, and because they don't stop playing it, you know, like they constantly.
Yeah, they're too addicted. I'd keep myself healthy. Obviously, I'm a very healthy individual because of football, but I still have that mentality, even if I wasn't an esports player or whatever.
Yeah. Riptide, what about you?
Well, another point that I feel is that if you are in physical sports, there's people that are like actually invested in your life, and I feel like there's more like, not exactly like drama, but you know, going on than if you were in an e-sport.
Yeah,
like you can actually do stuff and not have people like all
yeah
over
like there's
you
not
if
like
you're an e-sport.
There's not like camera crews following you everywhere you go, seeing what your life is like or anything. Like, you get to have a personal life, basically, is what you're saying.
Yeah.
So,
which I'd like that better than having people.
Yeah.
All over my life, because that just bothered me a lot.
Yeah. To me, I think I would have to go with esports, because here's the other thing, is that, like, Slushbon mentioned this before, but I've heard so many stories about, like, you know, people not being able to play the sport ever again, or having some kind of injury or something that debilitates them for the rest of their lives because they get too many concussions or something like that. And, you know, I mean, there's a certain point in which, like, okay, I will absolutely admit that you know, sports are good for people. You know, like, it's healthy. You know, it makes you a healthy person. But there is a point in which doing that can cause you to, like, all that training and health to be thrown away. So I think that, at least me, and there's plenty of, like, you know, there's plenty of athletes I've heard who say, it's worth getting a concussion over. I don't necessarily agree with that, but, you know, maybe it's true. Maybe there is some sort of, you know, like I said, I've never played football on any kind of team or anything like that, so I don't necessarily know the entire bond and the what would you call it, Slushbon? The sportsmanship of it.
What do you mean?
That feeling of that would the thing that would make somebody say playing football is worth getting a concussion over. What would you call that? What would you call that? Like
addiction
sports?
To the sport. I mean, I have that mentality, that love for the sport, that need to play the game. I think I'd go crazy without football. I definitely wouldn't be the person I am today. It'd be a lot worse. But yeah, football, it's a positive thing. I mean, I don't see. It's not a bad thing to have that addiction to the sport. You just gotta have your limits sometimes, because I've done
but
too
do you,
much.
Let me
I,
ask you this.
When I was
do
a kid, I practiced too much to the point where I broke my finger just by practicing so much. I got way too much into the sport when I was younger.
Do you really think, though, that it's okay, though, to be addicted to anything? Like,
can be healthy. You just have to have your limits. Like, you have to be a very... you have to have some self-control, you know?
Yeah. And I mean, I think it might be that our society's changed, or our society's always been like this, but I feel like nowadays everyone has significantly less self-control over what they do. You know, like I mean, I think the rise in obesity with, you know, I mean, there's like...
There's many,
300-pound people walking around on scooters.
We should probably get off that topic, by the way. just to not offend people.
Well, okay, so here's the thing, all right? Being...
Dad.
Listen.
Watch your words.
Listen. Being unhealthy is not a good thing. Nobody should try to convince somebody of that being obese is a good thing. Because there's people who do think that. And, you know, like, but I think that people, see, here's the thing. People either go, okay, we should just accept anyone who is obese, or we should shame all of them to the point where they just give it up. Which, both of those options to me sound terrible, because it's like, okay, which one of these terrible options do you want to choose from? I don't want to choose from either of them. Because, I mean, it's really as simple as don't promote it, but don't, like, be all,
encourage
like...
Encourage it.
Yeah, don't encourage it, but don't just be
like...
Like,
you can talk about it. It's fine. Just don't encourage it to the point where it's like, yeah, yeah, it's fine. I mean, obviously, it's a bad thing to be unhealthy.
Yeah.
It's I mean, like, some people can't help it because of how their body's built. Yeah. That's more of a genetic thing.
Like
that's very
rare.
Here's
what I say is that this is just kind of a rule, all right? Is that the point you know when you got a serious problem is when you're about average height for, you know, an adult and you weigh like 300 pounds or over. To me, that is the like, okay, pull back, dude. Okay, like,
right.
Get off the couch, like, because I think that that's, you know, like, for instance, all right, if you're the height of Shaquille O'Neal, of course you're gonna be 300 pounds, you know, like, there's nothing you can do about that because you're like a giant, you know. So that's why I said average height. But if you're like a 7 foot tall dude, then, you know, of course you're probably gonna be 300 pounds or whatever. But I gotta say that to me, 300 pounds seems like, unless it's all muscle, like Arnold Schwarzenegger level, then, I mean, you know, like that can't really be healthy, you know. Like, there's a pretty clear line between like obese and just being fat or something, you know. Like, I'm not saying that it's like, okay, all fat people, get your lives together right now. I'm not saying that. I'm more talking about, like, are you still there? Hello? Hello?
Just keep talking.
Okay. But I'm more talking about the people who, like, you know, have... Riptide, do you get what I'm saying? Can you put it into words?
Can you hear me? No,
yeah,
guys.
I can hear you now. But I'm more talking about, like, the people.
Hey, can
who...
I give a score update?
Yeah, give a score update.
Okay, score update. Panthers are down by set. Panthers score a 7. Denver Broncos is 16. So Panthers are down. But you never know, they could pull back because it is only the third quarter. And it's almost about 2 minutes to go. So the fourth quarter. So, yeah. It's, the game's nearing an end. But hopefully,
right.
I'm cheering for the Panthers. And I'm hoping they can pull back.
All
because
right.
I like Michael Orr.
Broncos.
You guys have a team you'd like to discuss? Because we got to stay on top.
No.
You like Broncos?
No, I, like I said, I don't care. I really, it's not that I don't,
okay,
like, I hate the sport or anything. I just kind of do.
That's fine.
It's just not
that's
my
fine
thing.
If you don't.
I'm not, I will not ever go, you're a terrible
Ted,
person for
we
liking
get it.
This.
You can say
okay.
It's not my thing and it's good. Ted.
Okay, fine.
It's okay.
Fine.
Rip-tide.
I got to fill time.
Rip-tide. No, dude, we're good on time already.
I know.
We're already fine. We've made an hour.
I know. Okay. Riptide.
Riptide.
Well,
okay.
I don't really care about professional, like, football. But I know, like, if my high school has a football game, I'll go to it and support my school's team. I just don't like. I don't care about professional football.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
But okay, I wanted to talk a little bit more about what I was talking about before.
Right. After that, we should end.
Yeah. But here's the thing, okay? And tell me what you guys know about this. But I don't think that necessarily that, you know, like, I'm not when I say like obese people, I'm not talking like about the guy who's like, you know, the necessarily particularly like, there's like, well, here's what I was saying. There's a difference between being fat and being obese. You know what I mean? Like to me, obese is when you can't, like you're not, there's certain things you can't do anymore, and it's like you can't, you know, like there's some people who can't walk as much, or just, you know what I mean? Like people who have to ride around on scooters, and like to me, that's what obese is, you know? What do you guys think? Hello, anyone? Anybody? Is anyone
What?
here looking for answers?
What was your question?
Replies. Do you ever listen to me?
No, my computer just cuts out sometimes, dude.
Oh,
I don't know why my internet's being goofy now. It wasn't like this earlier.
okay, so I said, what do you guys think about the difference? But do you guys think that, do you guys agree with me though, that there is a fine line
I'm not talking about obesity because people get
between
very
shut up,
offended
you
because that
get,
is a
shut up,
lot of the population of the US. It's not a healthy thing, but it's not
you get
something
to,
I'd
well,
like
you're
to
going
have a
to.
whole lot to
So,
say about
help
it.
it though.
Yeah,
Okay,
no, that's I
like
talked
I'm
about
not,
that
for
point
instance,
too.
okay, I'm not talking about people with like eating disorders or something like that, but I am saying though
No, I
that
mean like
for,
diabetes or something
oh
like that where your body doesn't metabolize stuff as
yeah.
well as it should.
Well, okay, so Riptide, do you think though that do you agree with me that there is a difference between being just a fat person and being an obese person? I don't mean to make fat sound so, whenever I say fat, it's like fats. I don't mean to make it, I keep saying it that way and I don't mean to. What do you think, Riptide?
Well, I mean, obviously, if you're obese, you probably need to do something. If you can't help it, I mean, you should still see what you can do. You should not want to be like that. I know people have been making it sound like it's okay to be fat, and I mean, if you have a like issue, then of course it's okay to be fat. But you shouldn't want to be.
Yeah, like
Like if you
okay.
are, you should want to be smaller, not like super thin or anything. Just it's better health-wise.
Like the way I always thought of it was that, you know, like you should never go up on the street and be like, "Hey, fat man, stop being fat," or something like that. But I mean, like I don't think anybody should, you know, want to be fat. Like it's the same sort of mentality of like say like a drug addict, okay? And I know that's a big leap, but the way I always see it is that I m significantly appreciate it more when somebody's like, I understand that I have a problem and I want to fix it, you know? Like they're not just like, oh, don't worry, it's fine. I'm good. My life's great. You know, like okay, I think that a drug addict who is trying to stop being a drug addict is similar to somebody who is, I'm not saying that the, you know, I'm not trying to be like, oh, fat people are just
We're over time,
drug
by the way.
addicts. Okay, it's fine. But I am saying though that there is an addiction involved. Both are addictions in a way. Would you agree with me, Suswan and Riptide?
If a slow spawn just completely.
Yeah, he just hates answering questions. Okay, Riptide, what do you think? Do you agree with me? Wait, what'd you say?
The question.
What's the question, really? Okay. I don't even know what the question was anymore.
See,
It
how can you
was.
expect me to remember it if you don't even remember it?
Yeah, that's I asked it, okay? It's not my job to remember it. It's yours. I think the question was like, do you think that, okay, do you think that like being fat or obese is an addiction in a way? And that it's the that no matter what, you should want to fight the addiction. You should not just be like okay with it.
Addictions can, well, it's a hard question.
Here's the thing.
I don't think of it as like an addiction. Just.
But is it not an?
I don't want to say problem because that sounds rude.
Well,
to people who actually have like a problem.
Yeah, I mean, we're discluding anybody who has any kind of condition that disables them from losing weight or anything like that, or so anything like that, diabetes or an eating disorder or anything like that. We're excluding all of that. But I mean, like, don't you think though that there is, it's either not wanting to do something or the continued indulgence of food, usually, or both, that somebody just doesn't want to.
It's split up, but
because here's another thing though.
I can see how people would want to do things, but they don't want to because they just have always not done it.
Yeah.
So they're used to saying no to doing things. So I get like, I feel like addiction would be saying no to doing things that would help with weight.
Yeah. But I gotta say this though. I can't believe the fact that we're all like, we're not trying to offend anybody, you know, who might get offended by what we're saying and all.
Dude, can we just do the outro? We've talked about.
Listen, it's like you said before, it's my podcast, all right? So I make the rules.
Can I, like, say my outro? Because I got crap to do.
Okay, say it and go.
Thank you for watching. Y'all are awesome.
Yep.
Bye. Okay.
Goodbye. But Riptide, though, here's something, though, that I thought about is that what does it say about us that we are all so PC to the point where it's like, okay, if somebody's unhealthy, we don't like to bring that up. You know what I mean? Like, think about it. We're trying to be all, you know, kind and nice, not try to be rude or upset anybody, and we're talking about like being healthy, you know? Like, that used to be just a no-brainer. You know?
Yeah.
Like, if somebody was unhealthy, you just said, hey man, you're unhealthy. Like, you shouldn't stop that. But now it's like, oh, what if the people watching get upset or offended? Or see, I don't like that idea of the world. I don't like that idea that everyone can't say anything that could be offensive to anyone. Because you know what? Anything that I say is offensive to someone somewhere in the world. I can't go my whole life being PC towards everyone and nobody ever getting upset at anything I say. You know? Like, I feel like we used to be much more tough. Like, we used to not be so wimpy when it came to hearing other people's opinions. You know what I mean? Like, yeah, I think the idea of
care more about
other people's opinions.
How we look. Or how, yeah, like, healthy we are, or other people's opinions about us.
Yeah. Like, I was listening to a podcast where somebody talked about this same thing. And they were saying that one reason that the idea of political correctness is ridiculous in a way, because it used to be that, you know, you didn't have to, at least not as much, but, you know, nowadays it's like people act as though, oh, you know, we're in a society where you don't have to care about what other people, we're trying to make a society where you don't have to care what other people think of you, and, you know, like, you can just be you, but by doing that, like, for instance, okay, it's now, like, this is the way they described it, all right, was that used to be, if somebody wanted to be transgender or gay or whatever, they just be that, and, you know, the parents would just be like, okay, that's, you know, that's your decision. But nowadays it's like I have to personally have acceptance for what, for who they are. It's not like I can disagree with them. You know? Like, it's now like you have to have others' approval in order for you to be happy. Like, your happiness comes from others' acceptance.
Yeah, yeah, I get what you're saying.
And it's like, I don't want to, you know, I don't want to accept everybody. Okay? I know this may sound, this a lot of people may disagree with me on this. I don't want to just accept the whole world and just be like, yeah, you know what? Everything that you do, every decision you make, that's just fine. That's just, you just be you. You know, like, there's plenty of people I think are idiots. Okay? I think that most of our planet is idiots at this point. And you know what? If somebody wants to go, well, no, you're totally wrong, and you know, you're being dumb, and I hate you because of that, and you should be ashamed of how offensive you are. If everyone in the world is going to be like that, then really, what? Like, okay, that is the opposite of free speech in every conceivable way I can think of it. The idea that you can't say something that would offend people. That the idea of free speech.
Well, really, there's not really. Free speech isn't real. Like,
well, what do you mean by that?
Freedom isn't really a thing.
What do you mean? Can you quantify it more? Because it kind of sounds vague.
Like, I mean, sure, we have free speech, but anywhere you go, there's going to be restrictions on that. Plus,
that, you know what? Actually, you're very right. Okay, here's an example. This is something, though, that I think we may have talked about this before. If a white teacher said to a black student something that was racial, you know, any kind of racial comment in a negative way towards a black student and the teacher was white, would that teacher be fired?
Probably it probably depends on how.
Oh, come on!
How bad the comment is.
You've seen the stories about teachers getting thrown out for all kinds of stuff. You know what I mean.
I think another variable would be how tolerant the school is. Like, if it's a school that just doesn't care.
That's true. But here's the thing, the activists would immediately be in uproar if the school didn't do anything. You know, and then in which case school would do something. Now look at it this way. If a black teacher said something to a white student, do you think that that same teacher would get in trouble for any variable?
I think it would be slightly different, but I still believe that they'd get in trouble.
Well, I saw somebody, an article or something that was talking about like white privilege or something like that. And they had all of these examples of teachers who have said stuff like on Facebook and things like that towards their students, where they've said real rude racist things to them, and they are still hired by like prestigious universities. But in other cases at those same universities, it'll be a white professor who will say something to another student that is of a different race, and they will get in trouble. And I mean, I don't want to get
professors into it. Have a lot more like, I think is, but like, they have a lot more privilege to say what they want.
Yeah, but both of these scenarios were professors. Both of these cases were professors, so they weren't like, you know, and it was like same schools and stuff like that. So, I mean, it's.
I know. I'm just saying, like, in general, I feel like professors have like.
I would agree with that. I think that's probably because publics, they're, you know, like there's not like, at least most colleges are privately owned. You know what I mean? So they don't have to answer to the government. But I mean, I don't know, I feel like our society has just become a bunch of wimps because we are too afraid to hear anyone else's opinions about things if they are not loving and accepting. You know? Like,
yeah.
People, I think people need to realize it's okay to just totally disagree with somebody. To, like, totally be like, I think that's wrong. Not, like, hate on that person, but just be like, nah, I don't think that's right, or I think that's wrong, or whatever. You know, it's not like, but now it's like, you know, you will be a social outcast if you were to do something that people found unacceptable. Now, I gotta, and here's an example. Did I send you that video about Donald Trump? I'm not sure if I did or not.
Tuck Frump video?
Yeah, that one. Yeah. So that's a, see, here's the thing, all right? No matter what you think of Donald Trump, I think it's good that he does not care about being politically correct, okay? If there's any quality that he has, that's the one I got to say. And here's the thing. You can tell that the mass media and things like that don't like that. Don't like the idea of... I heard somebody once say it like this, that the mass media has... The reason they show off so many liberal things and not conservative things is because they have to offer you freedom in some way, but they want to give you behavioral freedom rather than political freedom. Because political freedom can hurt them and behavioral freedom cannot hurt them. Does that make sense?
How did we go from sports to...
I don't know. Let's I just want to keep the train going for a few more minutes. So in this Donald Trump video that somebody made about, it was a bunch of Donald Trump haters who were saying how much all the things that they hated about Donald Trump, many of them not being true or inaccurate or things like that, in which this video proved that they were inaccurate.
If you are gonna say something about someone, you really need to be accurate on it.
But see, that's the thing, is that you can now just do that. You know, like, for example, the Fine Bro, what happened with the Fine Bros? So many people are going around saying, talking about that as though they know what they're talking about, as though they know anything about the law. You know, like, okay, I've spent a long, the past year, I'm still studying copyright law to this day on how it works because it's so complicated. But it's really complicated. You can't just be like, you don't know what you're talking about. Like, unless you are a freaking copyright lawyer, do not say that you know what you're talking about. Like, that's the thing. Don't say, this is a big life rule in my opinion, don't comment on something you don't understand. And that does not mean you Googled it or something. Like, this means either extensive research or you are in this profession, you know? Like, you're employed in this.
And I also feel like there's a difference between getting it and knowing it.
Yeah, like getting it means you can follow along with it if somebody were to explain it to you. Knowing it is recite. Yeah, like, you could recite it to someone. Like, you're the one on the other end of, you can, it's the exact same of learning versus teaching. You know? Like, for instance, okay, and here's the thing, there have been so many, like, big YouTubers who have gone around and have been denouncing the Fine Bros. I mean, and there's one YouTuber in particular, though, who did a really good video. You know the YouTuber Boogie something? Like, Boogie...
B2988.
Yeah. He did a great video on it where he talked about how... He talked it step by step of where people were confused and what it was actually that they were saying, and how the positives and the negatives of what they were saying could do. And it's like, nobody else did that. Everybody else that I saw pretty much just was like, wow, Fine Bros, you let me down this time. I mean, they'll be fine.
I really like Boogie2988 for that. Yeah, I feel like he does a lot of research and he actually knows what he's talking about.
Yeah, like I will say this though, the Fine Bros are going to be fine. If anybody's thinking, are the Fine Bros going to shut down now because so many people are unsubscribing? It's like the people who are unsubscribing is a drop in the bucket. Because here's the biggest thing everybody needs to know. Whenever you see people complaining, it's most of the time a vocal minority I've heard other people call it, and it's a minor group that decides that they are just going to be very, very loud about about their opinions, which then creates
it's always the people who are who don't know what they're talking about are the ones speaking the loudest.
Yeah. So a lot of people, so whenever you see people really complaining or something like that, it's not very many people usually. It's usually just like, what would you say? At minimum, okay, I'm not sure if people quite understand this, but like 10,000 people is not that much.
Yeah.
Like in the realm of the world, it's not that much. It's not like for instance, okay, I heard somebody say something about, you know, like Call of Duty or something like that. If you got like 50,000 people to show up at Activision and say, hey, make a different Call of Duty game, they would not care. They'd just be like, no. Because they don't need, it's okay if they lose 50,000 people. You know? Now, here's the thing. The consumer has a lot of power over people, over the
ones selling. I feel like Activision wouldn't just be like, no, we don't care. They'd think about it.
Yeah,
they'd take their opinion. It just wouldn't be like.
But people need to stop. People need to stop acting
as much as though, if like 500,000 people did it.
People, I think here's the thing: is that people need to stop acting as though their opinion is really important. Because ultimately, nobody's opinion is really that important, unless it's like, you know, for instance, if you're PewDiePie. And you say something about YouTube that's negative or something like that, then your opinion matters because are very important in YouTube.
Your opinion doesn't matter. It still doesn't matter, but you have more people that like follow you.
Yeah.
That being they trust you, they take your opinion to heart and believe your opinion. So that makes it seem like their opinion counts.
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, sure. In a way, it does. But...
Well, here's the thing. Celebrities' opinions should not matter at all. I mean, like, I'm talking realistically. We should not care about celebrities. You know? Like, a celebrity should not be really a thing. Like, you should not be able to be famous for something like being an actor or something like that. Because it doesn't really make any sense if you think about it. Because, like,
famous for, like, being an actor? I mean, if you're a good actor, then it makes sense that you're popular.
But why is it it's like you can only be celebrity by being a musician, actor, or, you know, like, all musicians, celebrities, musicians and actors are all celebrities. But it's like, for instance, why is, like, I don't know, I don't necessarily know who this is, but surely whoever the next Einstein or something is. Why is that guy right now not like world famous, or the next Sigmund Freud, or like people who are supposed to be really smart? And
they are world famous, just
in their own fields.
It's famous.
Yeah,
but like people in that field, they'd know them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But like who are like. Instagram junkies or whatever, they wouldn't care because it doesn't have to deal with them.
Yeah, but so like here's an example, right? I would say that actors, unless it's somebody really amazing, like for instance like Tom Hanks, should not be famous. I do think that, say, directors should be famous, because I think there are many great directors who are very, very smart people who have, you know, it's like the same thing of like an art. I mean, a director is an artist, is the same thing as an artist or a writer or anything like that. It's a form of artistry they're creating, you know? So, I mean, you absolutely have to give them credit and appreciate that. But, I mean, it's especially with music. Music's a good example today. There's so many people who can be copied. You know what I mean? Like there's so many people where if you replace them with another dude, it wouldn't matter. At this point, like today, music is not about voice, it's about sound. So if you can create a different sound than what people have already heard, then you are a good musician. But most of the time, like for instance, right, musicians, most of them do not make their own music, and they do not play instruments, and they just sing the song, and they just kind of sing kind of averagely, is most of music. Not all of them. There's many, many good musicians. Like for instance, Adele. Adele's a fantastic musician, okay, and probably one of the greatest ever. Somebody like Justin Timberlake. A lot of people might not agree with me on that, but I mean, okay, think about it this, all right? Justin Timberlake completely changed his image as a whole and has changed the kind of music he makes so much, so drastically in such short amount of time. And he's really talented. You know, like he actually is really, really talented. I would say The Weeknd's talented. Some people might not agree with me on that. Some people probably would. Although many people would argue this. And here's the other thing. You can not like something and still appreciate it for being talent or good or anything like that. There's nothing wrong with that. For instance, I don't like football. I still admit the fact that it takes serious talent to be a football player. Like I couldn't just go be one, you know. Like it's not like I could say, "Oh, this is easy," you know. Same thing with like being a YouTuber. Like I couldn't, you know. I am a YouTuber, but you know what I mean.
Like, I don't really think it takes talent to be a YouTuber, though.
I think it takes creativity, is what I'll say. It takes real creativity. I think that's the thing you need.
It takes creativity to be a good YouTuber, but it doesn't really take anything to be a YouTuber.
Yeah. That's much better of a point. But yeah, I mean, I think that now, over the past, I would say, 20 years, our society as an entire whole has become significantly worse. Would you agree with that? In every aspect of life?
Well, I mean, not in every aspect.
I'm not talking like majorly has become, but I'm saying in every aspect, don't you think it has become slightly worse? What do you think?
I said yeah.
Oh, I didn't hear you. It didn't pick it up, I don't think.
Maybe it was just too quiet for the thing to pick up.
But I mean, I don't know. I just think if anybody is still watching this, don't be uptight about everything. Don't act as though you have to speak the opinions of other people or you have to speak the opinions that are cool or anything like that. Here's what I always say is know what, here's what I always say is know what you believe and why. And if you can't figure that out, or it's not good of a reason, then you don't really have an opinion. You just have what somebody else told you.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, ultimately, like, for instance, do research on something before you have an opinion about it. Don't just, like, because having an opinion means that you think you know what you're talking about. Okay, so, like, talking about Obamacare, don't go talking about Obamacare if you've not researched what Obamacare is. You know, because if all you do is listen to what Obama says about Obamacare, you'd be like, oh, Obamacare is awesome. You know, like you can't go off of, you have to look at both sides of something before you can judge anything accurately.
Yeah.
You know, it's like if you, okay, like for instance, if you're like, am I a Republican or a Democrat? Go either talk to one or research what a Democrat and Republicans are about. Don't just be like, well, a Democrat sounds, you know, I like Bernie Sanders. He's saying some pretty good stuff. That sounds good. Because if you just listen to that, of course you're gonna like Bernie Sanders. Because you haven't heard anything else. I mean, that's what they do in North Korea. You know, it's you don't want to restrict your information. And I think that's what's happened, is that everyone now is just okay with just hearing something and being like, okay, that's true. Even though our world has shown us the exact opposite, that now you can easily fake stuff and you can just lie. You know, like for instance, that Donald Trump video. I'm sure nobody's been like, you know, nobody has gone on and I'm not sure it does. I'm sure it has like 10 million likes or something or whatever, you know? And nobody has cared to fact check it. Nobody's cared to be like, except that one guy, probably a couple other people, that, you know, this is total garbage and was just pretty much just made up by people who don't like Donald Trump, which, I mean, if y'all don't like Donald Trump, I can totally understand why. It's fine. But have a good reason. Don't just, I just want people to make a decision that is informed. Because I feel like most people today are too lazy to be informed. You know?
Yeah, they'd rather say something than actually know what they're talking about
Yeah.
and say something.
All right, man, we've been going for a long time. So, everybody, thank you for watching. I am Teddy Jenkins, and with me is my, well, he was here, but Slow Spawn, and with our special guest, Riptide. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.